Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. For more information on premium subscriptions or to sign up for a 30-day free trial, go to our financialsense.com website. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Joining us on FS Insider today is Jean-Marie Eveillard. He is a senior advisor to First Eagle Funds, and he is one of the most successful long-term value investors out there. We could rank him up there with Warren Buffett and many other very successful long-term value investors. Morningstar had even awarded him as building one of the most successful long-term records in the investment business. So with that said, Jean-Marie, thank you for coming on to FS Insider.
Thank you, Chris, and in particular, thank you for your very kind words.
Well, Jean-Marie, I know that you have been in the business for quite a while, probably more than 50 years, and you have seen just how much the investment business has changed, how much finance has changed. And I know that, you know, your particular focus is on value investing. So with that said, I want to ask you about the importance of value investing and how it has really shaped your success, and you think that just the value it should have for all investors in general?
Well, you know, value investing, and it's true. I mean, we, since 1979, we at First Eagle Investment Management have been value boys and girls. Now, the thing about value investing is, number one, at least to my mind, it makes sense. And number two, it works over time. So the puzzle is that, the late Bill Ruane, a couple of decades ago, estimated that there was about 5% of professionally managed money in the U.S. that was invested on a value investing basis, very broadly speaking, from Ben Graham to Buffett and everybody in between. So if indeed it makes sense and if it works over time, how come there are so few of us? Because I think this 5% probably still applies. I mean, there are people who say they are value investors when value investing appears to be fashionable, and then when it becomes unfashionable, they disappear. So, but the genuine value investors, I don't think there is more than 5% of professionally managed money that's invested on that basis. And so why so few? And I think the answer is almost entirely psychological. If you're a value investor or you're a long-term investor, it goes back to what Ben Graham said in his book, The Intelligent Investor, which Warren Buffett says is the best book ever written about investing, that short-term the stock market is a voting machine where investors or speculators or traders are at the mercy of market psychology. They vote with their purchases and sales of securities, and the result is almost entirely a function of market psychology. While long-term, the stock market is a weighing machine which weighs the realities of businesses, how successful they are, how profitable they are over time. And the value investor wants to be on the side of the weighing machine, not of the voting machine, not at, you know, at the mercy of market psychology, wants to be on the side of the realities of the business. And the realities of the business, usually they show up in the price of the stock. Let me put it another way. If I buy a stock today at $25 a share, and if 4 years later it's still at $25 a share, and if in the fifth year it goes to 50, I don't say, I wasted my time during the first 4 years. I mean, look at the stock. I mean, it went nowhere for 4 years. On Wall Street, they say it's sterile money. I don't think on those terms. I think in terms of I doubled my money in 5 years from 25 to 50. And the fact that the move from 25 to 50 happened entirely in the fifth year is very largely irrelevant. So the value investor is, by definition, a long-term investor. He wants, as I say, he wants to be on the side of the weighing machine, not on the side of the voting machine. And if you're a long-term investor, you accept in advance, that every now and then you will lag because you're not trying to keep up with your peers or with the benchmark in the short term. And to lag is to suffer. Suffer psychologically. You think you're an idiot. In the late 90s, I lagged for 3 years in a row, because I declined to participate in the technology, in what I thought was, you know, technology, media, and telecom mania. And, you know, in the third year, 1999, you know, I was going home and I was saying, what is it that everybody seems to see and which I don't see? Which is a way of saying, am I truly an idiot? So one suffers psychologically, one may suffer financially in terms of bonus, even at an extreme in terms of losing one's job. And if the money manager is a man or a woman in his or her mid-30s with two or three kids, losing one's job is not, that's what, you know, Jeremy Grantham calls career risk. And, you know, in the late 90s, after I had lagged for 3 years, I was then in the employ of a French bank. And the French bank, instead of firing me, they decided to sell the operation I was running, which was the, what at the time was called the Sogen Funds, for Sogen for Société Générale, the French bank. And then the investment advisory firm was sold to Arnold and S. Bleichreuter, and it became the, what is, at the turn of the century, it became what is the First Eagle Fund. So I was not fired, I was just, or at least my operation was sold. And I must say, I'm very happy that the operation was sold to Arnold and S. Bleichreuter, because I did not get along very well with the people at the French bank. Indeed, you know, I realized today that I wasted the first 15, that should encourage people not to be too pessimistic, in the sense that I wasted the first 15 years of my professional career. The first 5 years, because I had not come around to, I discovered Ben Graham only after having worked for 5 years. And the following 10 years, because the French bank did not let me invest even modest sums of money along the lines of Ben Graham's teaching. So value investing requires patience, not only on the part of the money manager, but of course, on the part of the investors. I mean, basically, we're running mutual funds. We have some institutional money, but basically, we're mostly a mutual fund firm. And mutual funds, of course, they're open to subscriptions and redemptions every day. And even if the money manager is patient, which I was willing to be, the investors in the funds may not necessarily be patient. Indeed, in the late 90s, when I lagged badly for 3 years in a row, between the fall of 97 and the spring of 2000, in less than 3 years, in a global fund I had won since 1979, so it had a long-term record already, 7 out of 10 shareholders bolted. After 1 year, they were displeased. After 1 year of my lagging, they were displeased. After 2 years, they were furious. After 3 years, they were gone. Now, you know, I didn't like the idea that, you know, 7 out of 10 investors left. But when I think about it, again, I mean, at the beginning, in 1979, when I took over the management of what became the First Eagle Global Fund, it was $15 million in size. By the fall of 1997, we were running $6 billion. It was not just one fund anymore. It was several funds. We were running $6 billion. By the spring of 2000, we were running a little more than $2 billion. So from a short-term standpoint, the move from $6 billion to a little more than $2 billion was not particularly pleasant. But today, we're running something like $90 billion. Which shows that since I was willing to accept that, now, I'm not taking the credit for entirely for the $90 billion, because, again, I've been in a position of advisor for 6 years now. But it goes to show that, yes, it was painful in the short term. But in the long term, from $15 million in 79 to $90 billion in 2015, I don't regret anything.
Jean-Marie, I want to ask you about the current market as it stands, because as we know, you follow Buffett very closely, and you are, like we said, a very successful and longtime value investor. You know, when we look at the Buffett valuation indicator, we see that it is at elevated levels. I think the only other time that it's been this high has been in the 2000 tech boom. We can look at Shiller PE, for example, which is also at a very elevated levels. And yet, when we look at the remarks by Warren Buffett and even Bob Shiller, both of them seem to be content in holding stocks, even though both of the indicators that are named after them or that they've created are showing elevated levels. So I guess, you know, from your perspective as a value investor, what do you think investors should be doing today?
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.